Hello everyone, hope you all are fit and fine. Very good. In the last video I had given you the notes related to roadways. That was the first type of land transport that we had studied. Now we come to the second type of land transport, that is railways. We are doing chapter 7, Lifelines of National Economy, and in that I told you that transport and communication are the lifelines of national economy. Now in transport, we started with land transport, already completed roadways, and today we are going to start with railways. So take out your books and be ready. Railways. Railways are the principal mode of transportation for freight and passengers in India. Freight means the goods. So the main mode of transport for people and goods, mainly for the longer distance and bulky goods, railways are very important. Railways also make it possible for people to conduct multifarious activities, different types of activities. What are these? Business. For business, people go here and there, sightseeing, so see different places, pilgrimage to visit the holy places, along with transportation of goods over long distances. So for pilgrimage, for sightseeing to far off places, people use railways. They prefer railways. And transportation of goods to the longer distance areas or bulky goods, all that can be transported with the help of railways. Apart from an important means of transport, the Indian railways have been a great integrating force for more than 150 years. It has been an integrating force. It has been joining the people, helping the people to mix with one another, understand one another. Alright, because of the railways, we are connected with every part of the country and we can mix with people, we can go to different places, understand those places, understand the culture of those places. So railways have played a very important role in integrating the country. Railways in India bind the economic life of the country as well as accelerate the development of the industry and agriculture. Very important for the economic activities, for taking the raw materials from one place to another, for taking the finished products. Alright, to longer distances you require railways, the bulky raw materials, bulky finished goods, all those can be taken only with the help of railways. So very important for the economic life. It has helped the industry a lot, it has helped the agricultural development also a lot. The Indian Railways is the largest public sector undertaking in the country. The largest organization under the control of the government is Indian Railways. The first train steamed off from Mumbai to Thane in 1853. So the first train in India started in 1853 and it covered a distance of 34 kilometers from Mumbai to Thane. The Indian Railways is now reorganized into 16 zones. Indian Railways, the railway network spread throughout the country. So in order to manage the railway network properly for administrative convenience, the railway has been divided into 16 zones. We are in the west central zone. Like this, there are many zones. This helps the government and the authorities to control the railway network nicely and manage it properly. The distribution pattern of railway network in the country has been largely influenced by the physiographic, economic and administrative factors. So the distribution of the network, the laying of the railway tracks in different areas have been affected by the type of land that is available there, the economic development of the area, plus the administrative factors. Will that area be properly looked after? Is it possible or not? According to that, it has been influenced. The northern plains with a vast level land plain area, high population density and rich agricultural resources provided the most favorable condition for their growth. So you find the maximum railway lines and trains running in the northern plain area because the condition is favorable. Maximum population is in the plain area, level land, plain land is available there, agriculture is there in plenty. So because of that you find the railway lines in maximum number in this area. The density of the railway line is more in this area. However, a large number of rivers requiring construction of bridges across their wide beds pose some obstacles. In the plain area, you have rivers also, and because of the river, some obstacle is there, because in order to lay the railway tracks, cross the river, you have to construct bridges. So that creates some obstacle. In the hilly terrains of the peninsular region, railway tracks are laid through low hills, gaps or tunnels, hilly areas. Most of you who have traveled through the Konkan Railway must be knowing now. In the hilly area, what they have done, they have made tunnels, and through the tunnels the tracks have been laid. In this way, the railway can carry on with their activities in these areas, hilly areas. The gaps and tunnels which are there, through them the railway tracks are laid. The Himalayan mountainous regions too are unfavorable for the construction of railway lines due to high relief. The land is very high and steep and rocky and everything. Because of that, there is a problem of laying down the railway line. Sparse population, that is population is less in that area, so it is not economical to lay the railway tracks there. And lack of economic opportunities are not there, less, then why to lay the railway tracks there? It is not economical to lay it there. Likewise, it was difficult to rail railway lines on the sandy plain of the western Rajasthan. On the sands, very difficult to lay the railway tracks. Swamps, swampy areas, marshy areas, waterlogged areas of Gujarat, there also railway tracks cannot be laid, it is very difficult. The forested tracks of Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Jharkhand, dense forests are in these areas, and there also it is difficult to lay the railway tracks. The contiguous stretch of Sahyadri could be crossed only through gaps or passes, that is the ghat. So again, the hills can be crossed only with the help of gaps or tunnels, otherwise not possible. In recent times, the development of the Konkan Railway along the west coast has facilitated the movement of passengers and goods in this most important economic region of India. It is a very important part of India. Economic development is taking place, but the problem was that rail transportation was difficult there because of the hilly terrain. What to do? Then finally, the Konkan Railway project came and tunnels were constructed, and now rail transportation is going on there. And it has helped that area to grow more. It has also faced a number of problems, such as sinking of track in some stretches and landslide. This is the problem in the Konkan Railways. Many places the land goes down, and because of that the track sink, go down, and landslide in hilly area during the rainy season, and all landslide takes place. The railway track gets blocked. The rail transportation has to be stopped then during those times. So these are some problems in the Konkan Railway, but still the Konkan Railway project has been accomplished and rail transportation is nicely going on in that area. Today the railways have become more important in our national economy than all other means of transport put together. You have roadways, you have waterways, but railways are very important, more important than all the other transportation systems. However, rail transport suffers from certain problems as well. Alright, every transport system has some problems. So rail transport also has some problem. Let's see. Many passengers travel without ticket. This is one thing that is being one major problem that is being faced by the Indian Railways. People travel without taking proper tickets. And in this way, what they are doing, they are cheating the railways. If the trains are to run, if the railway tracks are to be maintained, more railway tracks are to be laid, money is required. And if you don't pay and you cheat the government, then how will development take place? So this is a wrong thing that is happening. Many passengers, they travel without tickets. Theft and damaging of railway property has not yet stopped completely. Steps have been taken, but still people, they board the train, travel on the train, and from the train they'll take the fan and go, they'll take the pipe and go. The railway property is being looted, damaged. What is the need? But still it is going on. People stop the trains, pull the chain unnecessarily, and this causes heavy damage to the railway. In every compartment you must have seen there are chains and it is written, pull the chain to stop the train, isn't it? But it does not mean that whenever you like you start pulling and you stop the train. Train stoppage is there at the railway station. Time is there when the train will arrive and stop. But some people who want the train to stop wherever they feel like, they pull the chain. And then what is happening? The train has stopped, then another 10 minutes will take, then they'll come, they'll find out who has stopped, and all these things happen. Then again the train starts, and what has happened? Delay. And when one train gets delayed, other trains also get delayed automatically in that route. And that causes a lot of problem to people also, plus it causes problem to the government, to the railway management. Think over it, how we can help our railway in running as per the scheduled time. When we go to the railway station and we have to board train, and if it comes, the train is late and all, what happens? We get irritated. We don't want the train to come late. But why the train is getting late? It is because of all these type of activities done by some people who are there only to damage, who are there for their selfish purposes. Stop the train here and there by pulling the chain, and because of that train gets delayed. So such activities should not be done. Alright, railways are there, government is providing these things for our benefit. And if we only damage and destroy these things, then what is the use? Then why will the government also bother if we are not bothered? So it is our duty to take care of these things, and these problems which the railways are facing should be properly solved. Alright, and this can be solved only when people understand that it is for their use, it is not for misuse. I hope you have understood about the railways. So we'll start with the notes. Railways. The topic on top, railways. This is the second point of land transport. First was roadways. Okay. Write the first point in this. Railways are the principal mode of transportation. Railways are the principal mode of transportation for goods and passengers for mainly long distances in India. Second point. The Indian Railways is the largest. The Indian Railways is the largest public sector undertaking in the country. The Indian Railways is the largest public sector undertaking in the country. Third point. The first train in India ran in the year 1853 from Mumbai to Thane. In bracket you can put 34 kilometers. That is the distance. Fourth point. railways help people railways help people to conduct railways help people to conduct various activities like business sightseeing pilgrimage etc. Fifth point, railways have been an integrating force for more than 150 years now. Railways have been an integrating force for more than 150 years now. Sixth point. They help to bind the economic activities. They help to bind the economic activities. Join the different economic activities. Connection. Seventh point. They help in accelerating the development of industry and agriculture. They help in accelerating, speeding up the development of industry and agriculture. Eighth point. The Indian Railways is divided into 16 zones, for administrative convenience. Ninth point. India has the largest rail network in Asia. India has the largest rail network in Asia. Put the next heading, types of railway tracks. Right under this, there are three types of railway tracks in India. There are three types of railway tracks in India. What are these three types of railway tracks? They are classified according to the distance between the two tracks, the lines, railway lines. Alright, some have only is 1 meter, some have more than 1 meter, some have less than 1 meter. So according to the distance between these two railway lines, the tracks have been named. Let's see. First, broad gauge, put a dash and write 1.676 meters. Broad gauge, more than 1 meter is the distance between the two railway lines. Broad gauge, 1.676 meters. Second, meter gauge, 1 meter. Meter gauge, put a dash and write 1 meter. That is, the distance between both the lines is 1 meter. Third, narrow gauge, put a dash and write 0.762 meter and 0.610 meter. So narrow gauge, the distance between both the lines is less than 1 meter. Put the next heading, distribution of railway network, distribution of railway network in the country. Distribution of railway network in the country. Write the first point in this. Distribution is influenced by physiographic, comma, administrative and economic factors. Physiographic, administrative and economic factors. Second point, the northern plains provide favorable conditions, in bracket you can write level land, comma, high population density, comma, etc. and bracket close. So the northern plains provide favorable condition, in bracket, level land, high population density, etc., bracket close, after that, for the growth of railways. Third point, in hilly areas, railway lines are laid through low hills or tunnels. In hilly areas, railway lines are laid through low hills or tunnels. Fourth point, the Himalayan mountainous areas, comma, deserts and swampy areas have less railway network due to the difficult relief, that is the land features, difficult relief and other unfavorable conditions. In bracket you can write sparse population, that is less population, and lack of economic activities. Next point, recently Konkan Railway has been developed. Recently, Konkan Railway has been developed along the west coast of India. Recently, Konkan Railway has been developed along the west coast of India. Write the next heading, Challenges to Indian Railways. First point, It is difficult to lay railway lines in mountainous, comma, hilly and swampy areas. Second point, presence of so many rivers presence of so many rivers necessitate the construction of bridges, Third point, in some places railway tracks sink or get blocked. Due to landslides. Fourth point, the initial cost of laying the railway tracks is too high. Write the next heading, problems faced by rail transport. First point in this, many passengers travel without ticket. Second point, theft and damaging of railway property. Third point, unnecessary stopping of trains by pulling chains cause heavy damage to railways. So our topic railways is over. I hope you all have understood, you all have taken down the notes. Go through the notes. If any problem, doubt class is up there, you can come up with your doubts. And one more thing I want to tell you is about the internal assessment. Already you have been instructed what is to be done, so start doing and complete your internal assessment work. So be good and take care.